here. He looks to me like he's a hypocrite. That's what he looks to me. He looks like he's a hypocrite. He's just pretending, crying 4 days after this person has been buried, your best friend. You never saw him, you come crying. You know, what are you crying for? Mr. Jesus, God in the flesh. And when you don't ask the question, and when you don't bother my heart, I wanted to know why in the world did he cry? And the Holy Spirit said to me, and this is what I want to say to you, that Jesus cried not because Lazarus was dead. Jesus cried not because he did not attend the funeral. Jesus cried because they did not know him. They answered him. They talked with him. He ate their food. He shared the table with them. But yet they did not know who he was. So when he said, I am the resurrection and the life, they did not comprehend who was talking to them. So when Jesus looked at them, he looked at them and said, oh, these folks, they do not know me. They did not, they think, I thought that you guys know me, but you guys did not know me. I am God in the flesh. I am the Word that was in the beginning. I am the Word that was. I am the Word that is evermore. The best family, the closest of all, did not know who he was.
Jesus.
So when he said, I am the resurrection and the life. And they were saying, okay, we heard that before. He will resurrect on the last day. But we still say, have you been here? They did not understand. They did not know it's possible to be in the church and not know Christ. It's possible to fellowship in the church and not have an encounter with the real Jesus. It's possible to be in the activities of the church and yet not know him. The Bible says, when you shall know him, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. When you know the real Jesus, when you have an encounter with the real Jesus, when you have an encounter with the real Jesus, your life will change. They ate with him, they talked with him, he died with them, they have sleep in their house, yet they did not know him. So when he came, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. They did not understand. So Jesus cried because the very people who were his best did not know him. This afternoon, there's a possibility that you are in the church and there's something you've not known. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
To be here and not know who is here. You get too familiar with your pastor. You get too familiar with the man of God that you don't know that this has been sent by God. You were just like Mary and Martha. The way with Jesus, it is possible to be in a church and not recognize the grace that is upon this man of God. You don't understand that your prayer, answer to your prayer, is sitting before you. You can be fasting, you can be praying, you can be doing stuff. But when once you understand, the Bible says, believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. Believe in the prophets, and you shall prosper. The word prosper is to be able to move from one point to the other. I came just to talk to a few folks. Not everybody today. How many of you want to prosper?
Hallelujah.
Give me to Jesus. Give me to Jesus. I came not to preach. I came to recognize the grace that is in the house. Because it's possible that you could be in the house and not be able to recognize. You've gotten too familiar, like Martha and Mary, eating with Jesus and not know who he is. Like I was saying, thank you, Lord Jesus. Give me. I look at my boss, give me another $2 there. I want to recognize, because, you know,